Living here, you soon understand that Puglians love their greens. One in particular, Cime Di Rapa, is headline news. A favourite with orecchiette pasta. Now find some breadcrumbs in olive oil. They've just got a nice golden brown. And these are going to be served on top of my Cime Di Rapa pasta. Orecchiette Alle Cime Di Rapa is kind of the iconic dish for Puglia. It's a dish of the people, really. They often couldn't afford to buy cheese to put on top of their pasta. So what they would do is they would fry breadcrumbs to go on top of the pasta. This is Cime Di Rapa, and it's got a slightly bitter flavour. It does have to be very fresh. Can you hear that? It's surprising how much Cime Di Rapa you need. You get Cime Di Rapa really in the south of Italy, and it's adored here. When you get good orecchiette Cime Di Rapa, it is just, I think it is one of my favourite pasta dishes. It is so full of flavour.
Outside Italy, purple sprouting broccoli makes an acceptable alternative.
And this really is a very rough chop. The leaves will partially dissolve in the cooking water. I brought my salt pig with me. It's a bit of a classic British thing, a little salt pig. My main living room is actually the big square, the Piazza Plebiscito, which is where the world goes past. It's such a treat sitting here. A warm evening, windows open, warm air coming in, the last of the light going down. That is that. This is the way we usually buy chilies down here. These are classic Pugliese chilies. They may look quite innocent, but they are lively little so-and-sos. They grow beautifully here. And the third in this triumvirate of flavourings, an anchovy. I think I'm going to put in about 4 or 5 nice anchovies here. Sometimes when I'm cooking for vegetarians and vegans, I'll substitute something like some sun-dried tomatoes in for the anchovy. So these are our orecchiette, the little ears. I suppose they do look like little ears. Kind of very little ears, a bit vaguely. For this dish, you've got to be using orecchiette. It would, I think, be considered verging on criminal to use any other shape of pasta. Vast quantities of Cime Di Rapa go in, and it does cook down quite a lot, quite quickly. The Cime Di Rapa are cooked really till they're quite soft and beginning to collapse. I mean, frankly, bugger al dente, this is about softness. I'm going to add my pasta. There's so much about Italy which is beautiful. There's the food, obviously. And I've always had a particular yen for the south. There's something a little bit wilder, a little bit rougher about the south, a little bit more earthy. And I've mashed down the anchovy, and that's sort of dissolved into the oil. I need to take just a little bit of the cooking water. And this goes straight into the hot oil. And this is the point where I'm going to add a little bit of that saved water so that I can slick all the anchovy flavour and garlic flavour all over the orecchiette. Here we go.
And then there's breadcrumbs, the poor man's cheese.
I can have a little bit of cheese as well. I'm allowed to. I'm a foreigner. Here I am. You can hear the evening hum of people out and about. And I'm eating a plate of Puglia's very own orecchiette Alle Cime Di Rapa. It was worth that journey.
Heaven knows how many kilos of pasta are cooked and eaten each day in Celle. At one family restaurant in the old town, Maria watches her mother, Maria Victoria, as she methodically rolls and shapes the fresh pasta. I gather they will make about 6 to 7 kilograms of pasta every day. But it's not just old ladies who make pasta. My ex-landlord and postman, Vito, took me by the hand and led me to the pasta board.
So I'm just on the outskirts of Cime Di Rapa, and I'm going to visit my friends Vito and Anna Maria and their kids.
I don't believe it.
Vito is also the person who first taught me how to make orecchiette, Puglia's main pasta shape.
Although he taught me, I'm still not that great, so it's always good to learn again.
Because we're making these shapes which have to hold their shape really well here, you tend to have a stiffer dough than you would if you're making something like lasagna or ravioli.
Oh, so we're going to see if I've got any better. Oh, Lordy.
Questo credo che sia un grissino giusto.
Okay. Mine is getting there in its own special way.
Questo vediamo se va bene. Guarda, un impasto perfetto.
See, how easy is that? Anybody could do it.
Bello questo di questo.
He says mine's better than his. But on the other hand, I've made one. He's made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You get these sort of drag marks from the knife, which are absolutely typical. This is about catching sauce and flavour.
Se vuoi fare un'orecchietta più piccola, sai benissimo, ne fai là il grissino più piccolo e diventa più piccolo, no? Okay. Ti ricordi?
Le piccole sono per...
Sì, per i legumi, per...
So the smaller orecchiette are ideal for when you're having pulses, and having them with pulses. The slightly larger ones are ideal for cooking with cime di rapa, the green leaves.
That's not bad.
Ecco, sì. Bueno.
Now we're going to make a different shape. Cicatella, I love making these because they're really easy and they're fun. So you just press down with your three fingers and drag it towards you and you get this lovely curvaceous tube, open tube, ready to catch your sauce and to be utterly delicious. And that is how tubes of pasta are made. And there they are, magic. Oh, that's just showing off. That is the, like a rigatoni, so he's used the pasta board to give them ridges.
Voilà! Tu l'hai fatta! Sì.
Quali sono le migliori? Questi qui o questi qui?
Questi qui.
Ah, vediamo!
Questi sono un po' più larghi.
Sì.
Quelli sono un po' più...
Preciso.
The children very diplomatically said the ones this end were better.
Per essere cinese.
Give me 10 years and I'll be practically cinese.
E allora, possiamo mangiare?
Sì.
In this heat, the pasta is already pretty much dry, so she can get away with manhandling it like that.
Ah, buono. Chi è chi fa la cucina in questa casa?
Io.
Anna Maria has made a fresh tomato sauce for the pasta.
Pomodoro, cipolla, un po' di aglio, carota e basilico. E voilà!
Ah, nostro lavoro!
I think that's one of mine. This is really what life should be about, isn't it? This is Sunday lunch. It's special. Pasta is special here. It's not just a throwaway meal. It really is the stuff of life.